peace is generally defined as a wholesome state of quiet or tranquility, the absence of disturbance or alarm, and especially of war. Peace in today's terminology is the general state between people, social groups, or states in which existing conflicts are settled within legally established norms without violence. In religion, peace means security in God. Peace in the biblical sense is more than the absence of war. Peace means having good relationships with other people, with oneself, and with God. Peace is the situation in which human life and coexistence in every respect is such that people are doing well. Peace also means human beings maintain a good relationship to nature, to God's creation. Only when all creatures come into their own will there be peace. Inner peace means living in harmony with oneself. Inner peace enables one to find peace outwardly and to bring peace into the world. The idea of peace is also closely linked to the idea of justice. You can also create peace in the family. For example, when experience a dispute, you seek solutions that are good for everyone involved. Individuals are also of importance when considering large groups or even countries. Politicians, as individuals, are the avatars of war and peace. Peace must grow from within. This requires general conditions and a culture in which human rights and diversity are respected, participation and compassion are lived, and equal opportunities and justice are promoted. These ideas are shared by many peoples and religions.
I really loved it when one day I realized that in some cultures the word peace is used to greet one another, such as in the Muslim traditions. They say salam to each other when they meet, or the Jewish people, they say shalom. And I also searched for an equivalent in the German language, and I found it with Friede sei mit dir, peace upon you, but that one is not really used in everyday language, and I find that's a pity. Yes, and I also like the way yoga people greet each other. It's the namaste, which means the light within me greets the light within you, and you can also translate it with the peace within me greets the peace within you. Isn't that beautiful? I really believe that it is mandatory to develop a peace consciousness, because in order to have peace in this world, we have to realize the quality of peace within ourselves first. So that's how it goes. When we realize the quality of peace within, it becomes a reality in our lives, in our relationships, in our families, in our working field, in our society, our neighborhood. And one by one, that quality spreads and becomes a quality of a country, and in the end, a global quality. That's what I wish shall happen.
For me, the concept of attaining peace is a radical personal one by now. I think we all figured out that fighting for peace doesn't really work. So I almost see it as a life's task. We all know we have soul consciousness, and that's the only consciousness where we really probably can experience peace. So anything that happens to me that triggers any negative emotion or any irritation, I see as a task that needs to be overcome, a kink that needs to be ironed out in my consciousness. And to take that event into meditation and compare it or solve it in communion with that soul consciousness, to me is the way to gradually attaining a peaceful state.
Lake Shrine in Pacific Palisades near Los Angeles is a World Peace Memorial. This site belongs to the Self-Realization Fellowship, a worldwide spiritual organization founded in 1920 by Paramahansa Yogananda. Lake Shrine is a place of contemplation and spiritual renewal, and represents the unity of all religions. Behind the Golden Lotus Archway, in a wallless temple open to the sky, is the Gandhi World Peace Memorial. A brass container holds a portion of Mahatma Gandhi's ashes. It is the first monument in the world that was built in honor of Mahatma Gandhi, the greatest apostle of peace in the 20th century. Yogananda said, "The non-violent voice of Gandhi appeals to man's highest conscience. Let nations ally themselves no longer with death, but with life, not with destruction, but with construction, not with hate, but with the creative miracles of love. We must recognize the unity of mankind, remembering that we are all made in the image of God. World Brotherhood will reign when we have learned to practice the true art of living. This shrine is dedicated to all religions, that all may feel the unity of the common faith in the Fatherhood of God.